Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to use Keynote Live to give a presentation online with Zoom. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. I have a brand new course on using Mac Keynote. Now, one of the lessons in that course is about presenting over something like Zoom. And I decided, since that's such a hot topic right now, that I'd share the entirety of that lesson with you right here. If you're interested in the rest of the course, you can go to courses.macmost.com. There I've got the full course, which starts off with the basics of creating a Keynote presentation and then goes on to showing you how to use transitions, animations, builds, different types of media, and exporting and sharing your Keynote presentation in a variety of ways. Check it out, and here's a coupon to get 40% off the course from its launch until August 28th. So here's the lesson on presenting over Zoom. So a lot of times when we're giving presentations now, we're doing them online. And one of the most popular tools, of course, is Zoom. You can show your Keynote presentation several different ways using Zoom, but I think the best way is actually to pair Zoom with Keynote Live. First, let's look at how to do this using Zoom's screen sharing feature. Now, this isn't the ideal way to do it, and I'll show you why. First, let's go to Zoom here, and I'll create a new Zoom meeting. And now I'm going to invite somebody, and I have another Mac here, and I'm going to send an invite to that Mac here so we can act as a participant in this Zoom meeting. So now this Mac is going to join the Zoom meeting. We'll do it without video, make things a little less confusing here. And now I'll have to admit that person to the meeting. So what that person sees now is me, and of course they would see other participants and things like that. It's a typical Zoom meeting. But if I'm the presenter, I'm going to want to show my Keynote presentation. So one way to do that is to use share screen. Now I can simply bring up the Keynote presentation here and have it play and fill the screen. And then I can share that. So in Zoom here, I'll click share screen, and I could choose to share my entire desktop, and then hit share, and then I can go over here, and you can see the other person is seeing all of this. And now I can play this presentation, and they see just about everything that I see except for the controls at the top. And this works okay. I can't see my cursor here because Keynote has kind of taken over the cursor ability, but it'll work. It's just not ideal. So let's exit the Keynote presentation and let's do it another way. We'll stop the sharing, and instead I'm going to go to Keynote here and I'm going to use a new function that allows me to play in a window. And now the Keynote presentation is playing in a normal window that I can move around. I could resize and make room for other things that I'm doing, like controlling the Zoom presentation and everything. And now in the Zoom meeting here I can choose share screen, and I could choose the Keynote window rather than the entire screen and share that. Now the other person will only see what's in this window, and they're not going to see anything that's overlapping it or anything like that. Disadvantage is Zoom is really just grabbing all the pixels in this window and sending them. So if I shrink it down, the window will get very pixelated. Also, if I were to, say, move it off to the side there, it can't grab the portion that it can't see. So it's not quite ideal either. And if the other person's bandwidth is slow, they may not see all the transitions in a really nice way. I've got really great bandwidth here. Somebody else may not have fast enough bandwidth to actually see cool transitions, movements, and things. So let's stop sharing that way, and instead let's use Keynote Live to do it. So let's move the Zoom meeting off to the side here and go back to my Keynote presentation. I'll hit Escape. So I'm just back in regular Keynote document mode here, and I'm going to turn on Keynote Live. And what Keynote Live is going to do is it's going to make this presentation available for others to view it while I'm controlling it. So I'll be using two systems, Zoom to send my video and my audio, and for me to see and hear other people as well. In Keynote Live, a separate system that's just going to play this presentation online, and other people will be able to view it. So I'll hit continue here, and this sets up Keynote Live. Now I can invite viewers, and I can also go to more options here and I can get a link. It's very similar to setting up Zoom. You just have a link, you need to share it with someone. So I could just copy and paste that link into the Zoom meeting's chat if I wanted to. So I'll invite viewers and I'll do this by email and I'll send out another email. Now on the other computer I'll see the second email come in. I can select it and I can click the Keynote Live link. Now what that'll do is if I have Keynote on my Mac it'll launch Keynote and run Keynote Live there, which is great. That's the best situation. But what if the person doesn't have Keynote or they're on Windows, they can't even get Keynote? Well, then the link will open up in a browser. So let's simulate this. I'm going to drag and drop the link here to Safari so it would open up in a browser window. And now I see this little window here that says Welcome to Keynote Live. So now I have two windows open. I've got this window here with Keynote Live and I've got this window here with Zoom. And I could shrink that down and do different things with it. I could view them side by side. I could bring one in front of the other. Now here back on my main machine I can choose to start the presentation right away or play later. If I choose play later, notice here the play button changes to green to signify Keynote Live. And also there's a number of people that have joined. So let me click here and I'll play Keynote Live. And it'll start the slideshow and take a few seconds to get going. So now you can see I'm at the current slide of my slideshow. And as I advance, I see this on the other screen. It even shows the animation. So this is Apple completely handling the presentation here while Zoom handles the audio and video. Now I can't see anything but the presentation on my Mac, unfortunately. But the audience has the best possible experience. They can even expand this window, make it full screen. Now I can exit the presentation here. It'll exit the slideshow and I'll kind of freeze it for everybody else. If I go to Keynote Preferences and allow Mission Control Dashboard and others to use the screen at the same time, I have a little more options here. So let's continue the slideshow. And now I can actually Alt-Tab and bring up things like, say, the Zoom windows. And now I can interact with people and I just tab back to Keynote to continue with the presentation. Now if you want to see your presenter display, all you need to do is tap the X key. And now it'll show the presenter display to you, but the other person will still see the regular slideshow. That's a huge advantage for Keynote Live because you can see your next slide, you can see the time, you can even see your presenter notes. Matter of fact, if you go up here, you can click and customize the presenter display. You could even bring up the navigator over here and navigate through your slides, and they won't see any of that. Hit the question mark key or shift and the question mark key to see all the keyboard shortcuts. They're the same in Keynote Live as when you're presenting regularly. You can even press the H key to quickly hide the presentation. They're still seeing the presentation. And then all you need to do is switch back to Keynote and you're back here and you can advance to the next slide and continue on. Now here's one more option. You can go to iCloud.com and in there, if you have your Keynote presentation saved to iCloud Drive, you can access it there. Open it up and it's going to open up in the iCloud.com web version of Keynote. Then when you're in there, you can click on the little tools button there, click Use Keynote Live, and present from Keynote Live in Safari. So when we do that, the interesting thing is that we're actually presenting in a window. So now you can see I'm in a window in Safari. I can click and move to the next slide. And this is what will be shown over Keynote Live. Yet I'm in a window, not taking over the full screen. I still have the Zoom window open here and I can control things in the Zoom meeting from that while presenting from this window. And everybody else is seeing exactly the same thing. They don't have any idea that I'm presenting from the iCloud.com version of Keynote instead of the Keynote app on my Mac. It's the same to them. Now unfortunately you don't have the presenter display here. You only have some basic keyboard shortcuts that you can get to. So it's not quite as good as presenting from Keynote, but it does have the advantage of allowing you to have your Keynote presentation in a window and your Zoom meeting in a window both on the screen at the same time. So there are four different options for presenting with Keynote over Zoom. You can do a full screen share in Zoom. You can do a window share in Zoom. You can use Keynote Live from the Keynote app on your Mac. And you can use Keynote Live using the iCloud.com version of Keynote. Each has its advantages and disadvantages, so figure out which one will work best for you. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.